Okay, now I got it fixed. Sorry about that. So let's try it again.
Son. Well, he's
three are one. Now let's see if we can play them together. Since we did a blues song, I'll do something a little bit lighter and for us people that aren't as young as some of the other people. But I love that stuff. It's fun. Here we go. We'll just do something easy so that we can just praise our Father with, amen. Thank you. worship. Amen. Thank you, Lord, for saving me from all the empty things I chased. And thank you, Lord, for filling me with your amazing grace. My home now is heaven, replaced by your love. When I stand in your presence is when I worship you. Thank you for healing all of me. And thank you for restoring all to me. The joy of salvation comes only from you. When I stand in your presence is when I worship. Instruments. I hope everybody's had an extremely blessed Sunday. If you had a chance to go to church that you was able to. '60s. I think it's kind of prevalent for today, though. It talks about our Messiah being unidentified. Just listen real close to the words. He's an unidentified flying object. You will see him in the air. An unidentified flying object. You will drop your hands and stare.
You'll be afraid to tell your neighbor. They might think that it's not true. But when they open up the morning paper, you will know they've seen it too. For he will come back like he's promised, with the price already paid. And he will gather up his followers and take them all away. He's an unidentified flying object. You will see him in the air. An unidentified flying object. You will drop your hands and stare. An unidentified flying object coming back to take you home. An unidentified flying object, you will roll away. Your soul. And if there's life on other planets, then I'm sure that he must know. Cause he's been there once already, and is dying to save their soul. An unidentified flying object, you will see him in the air. An unidentified flying object, you will drop your hands and stare. An unidentified flying object, coming back to take you home. An unidentified flying object, you will roll away. You will roll away. Your soul. He's an unidentified flying object. You will see him in the air. An unidentified flying object. You will drop your hands and stare. An unidentified flying object coming back to take you home. An unidentified flying object. He will roll away. Your stone. Amen. Amen. Well, I want to do one more song for us tonight. And for the musicians there, I'm going to tune my instrument and I'll tell you what I'm doing. Brother Tom, he's a guitar player. So I'm tuning it down to a Celtic hornpipe tuning. Not all of it, just half of it. There we go. Does that sound good to you, Tom? Hope it sent you good enough there. But I want to share a story about the Messiah, the life of Jesus, and a lot of things that happened in his life. So this is the story of the Messiah, okay? He actually wrote the words to this song. I wrote the music to it. And if you like it, please share it. You know, I believe it'll speak to a lot of folks. The Messiah.
Some said he was an outlaw. He would roam across the land with a band of unschooled ruffians and a few old fishermen. And no one knew just where he came from or exactly what he'd done. But they said it must be something bad that kept him on the run. Some said he was a poet. He would stand up on the hill, that his voice could calm an angry crowd, make the waves stand still. That he spoke in many parables few could understand, but the people sat for hours just to listen to this man. Some said he was a sorcerer, a man of mystery. He could walk upon the waters, he could make a blind man see. He would conjure winding ways and do tricks with fish and bread. Yet he spoke of being born again and raised people. Some say a politician who spoke of being free, but was followed by the masses on the shores of Galilee. Who spoke out against corruption and bowed to no decree, and they feared his strength and power, so they lived in some said he was the Son of God, man above all men. He had come to be a servant and to set us free from sin. And that's who I believe he was, 'cause that's what I believe. And I think we should get ready, 'cause it's time.
Messiah.
served your people at this evening, your children. We have prayer warriors on here with us right now. If you have a need, please post it so we can pray for you and follow up with you. All over the country will have your strength to stand against evil, Lord, to stand against those that are trying to destroy America. This shirt that I'm wearing here, that's my design. We know what this is. This is the Torah of God, the written word of God. This is the Star of David, woven in a crown of thorns, representing Jesus who come from Nazareth. The heart represents the nations, everybody who is not Israel. The stake that our Messiah was crucified on for our sins, with the name of God on it, Yud Hey Vav Hey, written in Hebrew. And there's only one flagpole coming up, and Israel is connected to it, and America is connected to it. We must stand with Israel. We must stand with God. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem, because when Jerusalem has peace, the whole world has peace. And when Jerusalem is at war, the whole world is at war. And if you're a believer in the Messiah, if you're a believer in Jesus, He is a Jewish rabbi. He is a Jewish Savior who extended His grace to the nations. Amen. Can I see some amens out there? Amen. Because when Cornelius spoke to him, he said, "You only have to speak the word, and my servant will be healed." Amen. That's all Jesus has to do now, is to speak the word. And we have to believe and have the faith of just a small mustard seed, and we will be healed, and we'll turn our hearts toward God. Amen. 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 Another brother of mine, Brother Adam Fields, down in Florida, he's an Irish evangelist, was requesting prayer for his community. And COVID is hitting hard in his community. A lot of elderly people live there, and they're dying. And he is a wonderful evangelist. And he loves God, and he loves people. And Brother Philip, he walks the neighborhoods every day almost, praying for people. So dedicated to helping the homeless and those that can't help themselves. They have such a beautiful heart for those that are in need. Thank you. bless y'all. Thank you for staying with me. All my musician friends that are on here and all the states you live in, contact me. Maybe this summer we can all meet right here and do a big praise on the porch jam session. Amen. Thank y'all. God bless you.